In olden times, the creatures used to walk and talk together like men folks, and they planted their crops for food. One long summer, the sun was so hot that all the crops were burned up, and all of the drinking water was gone. There's no food nor water for the animals anywhere, except in one place, and that place was called the Clayton Field. Now, in the Clayton Field, there was a great big pear tree which was loaded down with ripe, juicy pears. And underneath that tree, there was a spring of cool water that never ran dry. So, one day, the poor, hungry creatures went over there to get something to eat. When the poor, starving animals came to the Clayton Field, a great big Bengal tiger rose up and growled at them. He said, "Be gone from here. If you don't, I'll eat you up. Be gone." And so the poor creatures were scared away over to the edge of the woods. Suddenly, a rabbit came along.
"What's the matter with you all?"
he said as he noticed their tongues hanging out of their mouths. "We are hungry and thirsty," they cried.
"Why don't you go over to the Clayton Field and get some food and drink?"
asked the rabbit. "The tiger said he'd eat us up if we came over there," the poor creatures answered. And there was misery in their eyes.
"It's not right for one man to have all the food and the drinking water while his neighbors starve to death,"
said the rabbit.
"Come closer, and I'll tell you how you can get the pears and water,"
said the rabbit as he jumped up on a stump. Then he whispered his plan in their ears. Next, he said out loud,
"Every man be here before daybreak in the morning. And if you all work together when I come, we will win."
Soon the next morning, the poor creatures were there. Br'er Turkey, Buzzard, and Br'er Eagle, and all the big fowls of the air came a-sailing and a-roosting in the tops of the tall trees. Next to get there was the tree-climbing creatures like Br'er Raccoon and his family and Sister Possum and her family. And then followed the little creatures like the squirrel and the muskrat and all the little birds. And the tiger was sound asleep under the pear tree. Just as the sun peeped above the treetops, the rabbit came down the big road with a rope around his shoulder, and he was a-singing loudly.
"Oh, Lord, there's a great big wind a-coming through the woods, and it's a-gonna blow all the people off the face of the earth, and I'm a-tying them down."
And then such a noise broke out in the woods as you never heard in your life. The bear began to beat on a hollow log. Big-a-bam, 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 bam, bam. And the turtle jumped up and down in another log. Big-a-boom, 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 boom, boom. The turkey buzzard and the eagle was just a-flapping their wings and a-shaking the trees. And the trees was a-bending and the leaves was a-flying while the little creatures shaking and the bushes in the ground and the little teeny ones was a-crashing around. All the time, it sounded like a slight coon was a-coming through the woods. All this racket so soon in the morning woke up a tiger out of a deep sleep. All the time, a rabbit, he was a-singing.
"There's a great big slight coon coming through the woods. It's gonna blow all the people off the earth."
And the people was a-hollin', "Tie me, but rabbit, or tie me." And then the tiger got so scared, he ran to the woods and put his head against a tree and begged Br'er Rabbit to tie him. He said, "Tie me first, Br'er Rabbit. I don't care what happened to the other folks. I don't want the wind to blow me off the face of the earth."
"I ain't got time to tie you, Br'er Tiger. I got to go down the road and tie the other folks and keep the wind from blowing them off the face of the earth."
And the bear was a-beating and the birds was a-flying and the wind was a-blowing and it seemed like the judgment day was a-coming to destroy the whole world. And old Br'er Tiger was so scared he couldn't move. And then he said to Br'er Rabbit, "Look a-here, Br'er Rabbit, I got my head up against a pine tree. It ain't gonna take but a minute to tie me, cause I don't want the big wind to blow me off the face of the earth." And Br'er Rabbit said,
"But Tiger, I ain't got time to bother with you. I got to go down the road and tie the other folks, I told you.
And the tiger said, I don't care nothing about the other folks. All I want you to do is to tie me so the wind won't blow me off the face of the earth. Please, sir, tie me. So while the noise which the creatures was a-making grew louder and louder, the rabbit tied up a tiger good and tight. And then he asked the rabbit to tie him tighter. And the rabbit wrapped him around so tight that the biggest cyclone in the world couldn't blow him away. Then the rabbit stopped all the fuss in the woods and called the folks around to see the tiger.
Look at this stingy man, he said. He had more than enough for himself, and he wouldn't give a taste to any other man. He's all tied up now.
Then the hungry creatures rushed into the Clayton field and filled their baskets and buckets with food and drink. And as they turned toward their homes, they began to sing. We thank you, Lord, that the rabbit taught us how if we work together, we will never starve to death. No, never.